Hi there, Jamie Keat here today at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day today. Today I want to show you five different reasons why you should start considering using the Microsoft Office app. So whether you're on your iPhone or Android, this will work great. You'll be able to create, to capture, and even edit inside this app. So let's get started on these five tips here today. So you probably notice I have my window of OneDrive open. The reason why I'm doing that is I just want to show you how everything is connected between using this app to OneDrive, even opening up as a Microsoft Word or Excel document as the app on your computer too. The next thing I just wanted to point out, notice if you look at my phone, I have my Office Lens and Office showing, and I used to use Office Lens all the time. And now Office Lens is actually inside Office, so I tend to use just the Office because it can do that and so much more. So I'm going to go ahead and open my Office app at the moment here. And just to look at it, just a little walk around first, you can see kind of some other documents or different ones I've edited today inside of it. But just at the very bottom, you can see there's the home, there's the plus and the actions key. So very simple to use. I'm just going to go back and forth between this. And just to show you where Office Lens is, if I hit the plus key, you'll see that Office Lens opens up. And now I can use it as a scanner just by selecting it. If I have a document, this magazine, I can go ahead and just find a certain, I'll just hover over it, take a quick picture. And so at this point, Office Lens allows me to pick what out of there I want to take. I can size it so I can maybe pick one little area of this if that's all I wanted. And you can see how you can really customize it, but I'll just hit confirm and I can hit done and I have this quick scan. And I can do things on this. Now at this point, you can check at the very bottom where I can select it. I can create a PDF out of this. I can share this. So there's all these different things that I can do from Lens right here. I could hit the more and you can see I could create a PowerPoint, create a Word. If I create a Word from it, it actually just pulls the text right out of here. So if I go ahead and create Word, you'll be able to see that it takes that little bit of text in it and this is Word. So you notice I can click in different places and I can start editing this too. So that's using Microsoft Lens, but that's not really how I use it as much anymore. I want to show you how I just use it right from the Office app and all the different ways that you can do it. And I kind of skip from going to that Lens, but it kind of works similar. This time what I'm going to do is just hit the plus here and you're going to see that I can create documents like Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and Forms right from here. So I'm going to click on Word and you're going to see some options that I get. There's scan text, dictate, blank document. I can even create from a template right from my phone. So in this case, I just want to show you scan text. I'm going to use that same magazine again. So if I hover over it here, I'm going to go ahead and take the picture of it. And now at this point, you can see again, I can adjust it somewhat up in the corner to get what I want. Maybe I'm gonna move this over again right to here. So it will have a little bit extra stuff. Maybe I have to edit it a bit in the Word, but if I hit confirm, and then you can see how I can add filters and I can crop it. And I'm not gonna go through those things, but if I hit done at this point, it's gonna actually open it up in Microsoft Word. And sometimes when there's graphics and different things in it, things will be messed up a little bit and put in different places to it. But you can see how quickly that was in live time that it kind of went through and pulled from the magazine. Now it left an image that I was going with. If I took maybe just a single page, it would just come across a lot quicker that way. But this is something fun to kind of play with and how quick it works to pull the text right from the magazine. If you look at the top, you'll see a share button beside those three little dots in the top right. I'm going to click on that. This is where I can rename it. So if I was going to call this demo, you can see where the locations where I could save it. If I go to location, I could choose where I want. I wanted to save it to OneDrive, so I'm just going to hit save in there. So now I'll be able to access it through my OneDrive or even Microsoft Word on my computer as long as I'm logged in. And I can see that it updated right here while I was talking. I'm going to just click on it and we have this, we'll show you a little bit better now, the same document as it goes through. and I'll just scroll down. You can see how it looks a little bit better over here. And I can even, if I go ahead and open up my Microsoft Word like this, as long as you're logged in, you can go ahead and I'll go and open that same document in here. There's the demo one, and I could be working right from here at the same time. So you're connected all through OneDrive where it's being saved. So now I want to show you something cool you can do in Excel right from the Microsoft Office app. I'm going to go ahead, hit that plus again, and this time I'm going to select Excel. You can see it's the second one. I'm going to select it, and then I'm going to choose scan table. So I'm going to pick that, and I just have a printout, and imagine if you had a little table in a magazine or something you want to grab. But let's say if I just want this right here, I'm going to scan this, and I know these are just tables from Excel, but just for a demo, you can go ahead and try it on some tables. I'm going to size this a little bit different to make sure everything matches in right through here, because I don't want to get the extra stuff. I'm going to just go ahead and confirm this like so. So now what it will go through, it goes through and it will actually ask me if certain things are correct or not, if it's having trouble reading any of the information. You can see down below, it has some red items on it. So I'm just going to go ahead and see what happens when I hit open on this right at the very bottom. So I'm going to hit open, and it says, do we want to open anyway or review the items? I could quickly scan over it. It will review each one. If I hit review, it'll go to each spot and ask me, is this what you want? Or you can actually even change it. I'm just going to hit open in Excel. And then you can see this way right here, if I hit the, if I hit it right here, and this is in Excel in the table formats, and it just put it into the cells like this. So now at that time, if I wanted to go, I could go and save it just like I showed you before, hit save, and it's going to go over to my OneDrive, and I could be, well, I could be working on my phone, or I could go over to my OneDrive and work from it there, just exactly the same way that I showed you when I showed you with Microsoft Word. Now I'm going to select the More Actions button at the bottom right-hand corner. So I'm going to select that, and you can see all the different things now you can do, especially working with PDFs. And I really like a few of these, and I'll just show you three of them, and then you can start playing with even more of the options here. But at the top, you can see we already did the image to text and image to table, but you can even sign on your phone. So if you have a PDF you need to sign, you can go ahead and I'll say sign PDF, and I'm going to go ahead and browse. I'm going to grab a document from my OneDrive, let's say, and this time I'm going to pick this right here, this signing PDF. I think I already had it over, but let's say I needed this document signed for some reason. I created this, and I could just go ahead and tap it. So now it changes, and I'll just quickly sign my name with my finger. I know this is going to be messy, but I could store my signature. I'm just going to hit done. So it puts it on there. I can click on it. I can move it around. I can size it how I want on there and hit the check mark in the top left. And I have this document signed. So that's how quickly you can do this on your phone, signing a document right inside using the Microsoft Office app. Before I get to the next thing I want to show you on the app, I just wanted to show you inside Office here, or sorry, inside OneDrive, when I open up that document, you can see my signature on that document. Again, how everything is syncing. Now, just looking at scrolling down a few options here, and we're going to go document to PDF on this one. So maybe you have a document in Word, you want to quickly turn that to PDF. You're not on your computer, go document to PDF, just select which one you want. I selected demo to PDF because it's just for a demo. Let's say we have this one, bottom right hand corner, hit that orange upload. Where do you want to upload it to? I can just title it the way I want it, and then I hit upload. And remember, this is going to put it in OneDrive as a PDF. So you're going to see this get updated over here, and then we're going to move on to our next one. So there, demo Word to PDF. If I open it this time, it's going to be just a PDF that used to be a Microsoft Word document. With the PDF to Word, I can go ahead, I'll select that one. I'm just going to pick the signing one that I already did. It's actually a PDF that I created in Canva, so it was just a straight PDF. And I'm going to just open it up this way, but it might not look like anything changed. But at this point, if I select anything in, if I click on in any of the areas, you'll see that I can start to edit it. So if I go and just click on here, just like this. I'll zoom up and then I can go in here and I can start to change the names. Very easy. I could click around and even work on my phone. Remember, if you want to work on your computer, maybe you could just go ahead, upload it like so, and it's going to go over to OneDrive, and then you can work from your computer and working in an easier document to make any of these changes to it. Now, I just want to say with your app, if I'm just going to go back here a couple steps to the home screen, if you don't have the document inside here, so if you don't see a document you want to open, you can click that little folder up top in the top right hand corner. So then you can go ahead and go to OneDrive if you want to grab something and bring something over if it's not there in your list. So I just wanted to give you these tips today, these different tips in order to kind of just get you playing around with this app. You can do a few more things in here that are great with working with PowerPoints, time rehearsing, just hit the more actions and go through that big list. Everything's very easy to use. And remember how everything's connected over to OneDrive and all your other apps on your computer. So you don't always have to be working on your phone. If you start it, you can switch over at a later point. So I hope you found these tips useful today in using this Microsoft app on your mobile device. I know for me, it works great. Let me know what you think in the comments down below, what else you're looking to learn. Thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.